All right, part three. The clerk, who is the administrator of the CESK Trust, then appointed you, Judge, as the trustee for the trust. And since neither of you can be the beneficiary, that leaves me. And therefore, you are my trustee. So as my trustee, I instructed you to discharge this entire matter with prejudice and award the penalties for these crimes to be paid to me in compensation and damages for my false arrest. Note, the law of trusts dictates that an administrator, trustee, beneficiary cannot serve two positions in a trust, so a trustee cannot be a beneficiary too. Okay, hold on, I gotta sit the camera down. Okay. I am the living woman, Carol Lee Bohannon, have suffered numerous damages as a result of the arrest, whereby I direct that the trust compensate me from the proceeds of the court. I wish to be compensated for, see the refer to the fee schedule attached and included with this mailing. The dollars amount is listed for each of the damages in redemption. Additionally, included and in addition to the fee schedule on a case appealed to the United States Supreme Court, Trezevant versus City of Tampa, wherein he was arrested, $25,000 for 20 minutes, wherein he was unlawfully incarcerated in jail. The United States Supreme Court upheld the lower court decision. I was unlawfully kidnapped, trespassed upon my life, and jailed for nearly 5 hours. Verbally abused, coerced, intimidated, forced to walk on a leg bone, which is splintering off in my foot bones, as I recall the x-rays showing years ago. A right knee that needs replacing, which also has a torn meniscus, two hips needing replacing, left ankle needing replacing, a spine which is collapsing from the neck down, broken vertebra, healed ribs, having dead bone throughout my entire body, called osteonecrosis, osteopenia, holes in the bones, osteoporosis, weak bones, severe spinal stenosis, severe rheumatoid arthritis, three eye diseases, macular degeneration, glaucoma, and I forgot the third one, sensitive to temperatures wherein that made it cold in my cell, threatened me with bodily harm and injury, injured due to my disabilities, traumatized, experienced mental anguish, and made to be under stress, which has caused a further decline to my health and well-being, as well as my service dog, having heard all the commotion before getting taken against my will or consent, wherein he could not come to my aid. I have not recovered. To the best of my recollection, there are 1,440 minutes in a day, and my freedoms being infringed upon comes to 126,180 minutes from January 16th to the court date of April 14th, 21, calculates to 180,000 dollars, I'm sorry, pertaining to the above case number. If by chance the case is dismissed with prejudice prior to April 1st, 2021, the said fee would be reduced from the present amount listed herein, being under no obligation to this court or anyone save my Father Creator, I submit you the trust herein. Continuing, for and on the record, Liberty Mutual had a legal, lawful, binding obligation contract with me since 1981, my first injury, 1983, my second injury, both due to unsafe working conditions. To present, they have been in contempt of their court orders to provide my medical care, have caused further injury and detriment to my health and well-being, has colluded with my numerous doctors, whereby now I have only one, which has nothing to do with their coverage, has incarcerated me intentionally for 30-some years, threatened me for exposing their evil actions to the public, not providing the care or apparatus medical equipment supplied needed to live my life as a result of my work injuries, collusion with the Kentucky Department of Worker Claims ex parte dealings with them. I was never made aware of preventing my responses to actions behind my back. I, the living woman, never threatened their lives. I used the law they are to abide by and obligated to. I gave them notice after notice after notice, but they declined doing the moral just actions to fulfill their obligation to me. I told them for years I would eventually and lawfully come against them. I attempted to not file the private non-commercial lien, non-judicial, since last year, whereby they tacit acquiesced and defaulted. So because I, Carol Lee Bohannon, sought justice lawfully, then pay you corporate entities to play the heavy. Well, folks, the lien has already been recorded in the public record, and it cannot nor shall be removed until they pay their debt. So if I should die before they do that, well then, it will hang over them for 99 to 100 years. No one but me can withdraw or remove it. They prevented me from living my life. They imprisoned me. They kept me from my family. They stole my life. You should be going after them, but the public knows how you play. Corporate helping corporate. Your response is required within 3 days, addressed to my domicile exactly as written below. And they have not responded. And this was sent to Henry Brennenstahl, Misty Miller, Judge, Sheriff Keith Kane, Bruce Kegel, Prosecutor, Claude Porter, County Attorney, Jennifer B. Secker, Clerk, Daniel Cameron, Kentucky Attorney General, or District Attorney, whatever the hell he is, Arthur Elam, Chief of Police, Janet Yellen, Secretary of the United States Treasury, General James McConville, Chief of Staff of the Army, Merrick Garland, United States Attorney of the Department of Justice, and all the people that are judges on that. And this was all stamped, sealed, notarized. Okay, next item. They were in receipt of March 4th, 2021 was when I typed this. This is a FOIA request to both the Sheriff's Department and Police Department. You have 20 days to be in compliance for the request for the following: Freedom of Information Act, expedite pertaining to the copyrighted fiction names and any and all derivatives thereof for Carol Lee Roberts, etc., Carol Lee Hicks, etc., Carol Lee Bohannon. 1. First and last names of all duty sheriff deputies, along with badge numbers working the day of January 16, 2021. 2. First and last names of all on-duty police officers, along with badge numbers working the day of January 16, 2021. 3. Sheriff's Department and Police Department, all body cam footage a half hour before, during the incident, and a half hour after the incident concluded. 4. Sheriff's Department, Police Department, all dash cam footage a half hour before, during the incident, and a half hour after incident concluded. 5. A 911 calls to include public a half hour before, during the incident, and a half hour after the incident, and non-emergency calls. 6. Dispatch and radio calls a half hour before, through the incident, and a half hour after the incident. 7. Sheriff's Department, Police Department, all written reports. 8. GPS locations of the sheriff and all deputies beginning at 11 a.m. January 16, 2021 for the entire day up to the incarceration and a half hour after the incident. 9. GPS locations of all police officers beginning at 11 a.m. January 16, 2021 for the entire day up to the incarceration and a half hour after the incident. 10. All incoming phone calls received from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. January 16, 2021. 11. Name, address, phone number of ambulance service along with who called them, their full name and badge number along with ambulance personnel. 12. All recordings, videos, phone calls, written reports to them and from them along with directives of the ambulance service. 13. All medical reports, staff reports, first and last names of all interactions from everyone at the Davis County Detention Center, as well as security observation cameras footage. First and last names, 14. First and last names of the two police officers which drove me, the real living woman, Carol Lee Bohannon, home. 15. All personal phone, cell phone records and text messages. 16. Because we know they use those on the job. 16. Full names and badge numbers of who called the record service, along with the record service name, address, phone number, and the recording of that call and text. 17. In addition to the above and under separate mailing being as a total second request, any and all phone calls made about, to, and from the below listed address from October 1977 to present, dash cam footages, text messages, unit-to-unit transactions, 911 calls, dispatch calls, body cam footage, all complaints and phone records pertaining to, about, or from said address, full names of all officers or sheriff deputies involved with badge numbers, names, and addresses of those making complaints or calls, private cell phones, the mailings, text messaging, all emails sent to the Sheriff's Department and Police Department. Mail these items to and exactly as addressed below. Okay. Common law trust. Tax-exempt foreign status, public notice, public record. For the purpose of this common law trust, the terms United States and U.S. mean only the foreign federal legislative Democracy of the District of Columbia, D.C., federal corporation, state. The term state means the several states, the District of Columbia, the Commonwealth of Puerto Rico, the United States Virgin Islands, Guam, American Samoa, the Northern Mariana Islands, the Trust Territory of the Pacific Islands, and Indian tribes defined pursuant to the Secretary and any other territory within the United States. Which entity has its origin and jurisdiction from Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17 through 18, and Article 4, Section 3, Clause 2 of the Constitution for the United States. The terms United States and U.S. are not to be construed to mean or include the sovereign people or any of the 50 unity states of America. Neither born nor naturalized in the United States, nor subject to its jurisdiction. Did you get that? I am not now, nor ever have been, as described in 26 Codes of Federal Regulation, which is CFR 1, period 1, dash 1C. And the 14th Amendment, a U.S. citizen. Therefore, I am foreign with respect to the United States. I am not now, nor ever have been, as defined in 26 U.S.C. 865G1, capital A, a resident of the U.S. I have never made, with any knowingly intelligent acts, Brady versus U.S. 397, U.S. 742 and 748, any voluntary election under 26 U.S.C. 6013 or 26 CFR 1.874-4 to be treated as a U.S. resident alien for any purpose. Further, I have utterly no intention of making any such election in the future. I am not one of the sovereign people, American. I am a non-taxpayer. I am not now nor ever have been defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. 7701A30, a U.S. person. I am not now nor ever have been defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. 7701A14, a taxpayer. I do not have now nor ever had defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. 911D3, a tax home within the U.S. I am outside the general venue and jurisdiction of the U.S. federal corporation. I am not now nor ever have been defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. 3401, an officer or an employee or an elected official of the United States, of a state, or of any political subdivision thereof, nor of the District of Columbia, nor of a domestic corporation earning wages from an employer. I am not now nor ever have been defined pursuant to 31 U.S.C. 3713, a fiduciary, or as defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. 6901, a transferee or a transferee of a transferee. I am not now nor ever have been defined pursuant to 26 U.S.C. subtitle B, a donor or a contributor as one of the sovereign people, American, I am exempt from any gift tax under 26 U.S.C. subtitle B. As one of the sovereign people, American, not engaged in or effectively connected with any trade or business within the United States, I am not required by law to obtain a U.S. taxpayer identification number or a Social Security number because of my exemption under 26 CFR 301.6109-1G. Further, I am not required by law to make as defined pursuant to 26 CFR 1.6015A-1 a declaration because I am exempt.